Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred TV with another unboxing and review video. But wait, there's a theme, and the theme is things that suck. And in this scenario, I am including all of my YouTube videos, but let me show you what I'm filming. It's the Dyson Ball Animal 2 Vacuum Cleaner. Yes, things that suck. Okay, so you gotta love the word Dyson. Why?
Because it has the word die in it.
Okay, so a little bit of editing. We add in an apostrophe S. Okay, so now it's Dyson's ball. So it's either a testicular reference, or you can make a urology joke, whatever. So a suite of Dyson dirt-sucking products were on deep discount during the holidays. Yes, this thing was purchased in December. I think they had like about, you know, almost like 30, 40% off. I bought two of them. One is replacing a Dyson model that's colored in gold. It doesn't suck as good as the purple one does. And this one, and then the second one is replacing another purple one, same model, that I bought reconditioned on Woost. But it had like a small mechanical failure, minor, but enough to drive my OCD off the wall. Never again refurbished from Woost. I say nay, nay. Let me unbox this thing. Okay, so there are all the components, but there's all the shrapnel from the packaging. I gotta go throw that out. Now, by my own admission, I'm not very good at assembling things. Install Windows XP on a virtualized machine? No problem. XP, best operating system Microsoft ever came out with. Let's see how long it takes it to assemble this vacuum cleaner. Okay, and the assembly is complete, and it honestly only took me 9 minutes. I think my biggest difficulty was seeing the instructions. I had to pull out a magnifying glass. 9 minutes, and the assembly is pretty much click, 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 clackety, click. You just kind of snap together, really no big deal. And I used the quick and dirty assembly procedure that was kind of like strapped to the device. Ironic, I'm using something quick and dirty with a vacuum instead of using the full instruction manual, or manuel, as we call it in South Florida. All right, acoustic test. Sucking power, excellent. Boy, this rug sucks, but so does the vacuum. Yeah, whatever. So I'm replacing this one with this one because this one sucks less than that one. I guess that makes sense. I'm gonna roll this one down to a friend. Nice. I had vacuumed these rugs only like a day ago with that one, and holy crap, this thing picked up a hell of a lot more dirt. So and you can feel it when you're vacuuming. It really locks down onto the rug. Very impressive. Oh, and here's the acoustic test on the other one. That's what this one sounds like. You know, and I know Dyson has a whole new line of vacuums that just recently came out. They're very slim, they're very portable, they're supposed to be more powerful than that thing. But it just the form factor, they're just too small and they're battery powered. I like a big FF class vacuum with a power cord. So, but there's one more thing I wanna check on. Let's see. You know, so Dyson is very big on registering your product, okay, and putting the serial number and whatnot. And when I purchased them online, one of the selling features is that they're gonna automatically register the product. And even Dyson asks a whole bunch of demographic and psychographic questions. I filled it all out. I mean, he's building a nice database. God bless him on that. When I went to check on the order status, I didn't see the products registered. I then did like a text messaging, whatever, with customer support, and they said that they had like failure with their back-end system. So the real test is I'm gonna log into my
Dyson
account and see if the two vacuums are indeed registered. Let's find out. Okay, so let me get the program ScreenFlow running on my Mac system so I can give you a pure, clean video feed. I'm lying. I'm going to point the camera at the Dell monitor. And I'm on the Your Dyson Technology Mr. de Blasi page, and nothing, nothing. And then I went into order history, nothing. So they had a nice IT failure during the holidays. Well, Dyson, I guess your IT infrastructure sucks. You better L your hardware vendor. Oh, that's such a great line. Okay, and this is the new form factor of the new Dyson vacuums. I don't know, I just don't vibe with this thing. It's just, it's just
too small, too delicate. I mean, a vacuum got to be a vacuum.
So in my opinion, if you can get a good deal on that purple Nurple, get it. That's a good kick-ass FF class vacuum. That's all I have to say. More to come. Stay tuned.
Madeline, we're standing in front of the data center on the ship. I'm going to take a peek through the window. There it is. There's the network operations center. Madeline, my question is, are they running Windows XP and Fox Pro?
Absolutely.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.